So you saw many of your pages falling into this crawled currently not indexed and discovered currently not indexed categories in your Google Search Console, and you're wondering, are these serious issues? I believe the content on my site is great, but why aren't Google picking them up? Don't worry, even the most legit site runs into these issues, so let's get to the bottom of this. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one tool that provides easy-to-use SEO and AI tools, and this channel provides you with tips, tricks, and tutorials to help you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, consider subscribing. So all the pages listed in the two categories are not indexed, but what is the main difference between crawled and discovered? It's simple. Crawled but currently not indexed means Google has crawled the pages but has decided not to index them, so they won't rank. While discovered means Google is aware of the pages, but they haven't crawled them yet. Putting into context, one is more serious than the other. If a page is supposed to be indexed but lands in the crawled category, it means something is wrong with the page. But if it lands on the discovered category, you just have to give Google some time to crawl the page. All right, so let's talk about how to identify these issues. When you log into your Google Search Console, visit the Pages tab, scroll to the bottom where they will list all the issues of why your pages aren't indexed. And over here, you'll see discovered currently not indexed and crawled currently not indexed. Click through either one of the issues and you will see the pages that are affected. Now, if you're using RankMath, you don't have to visit Google Search Console because you can access the data right from your site. To check out the index status of your pages, you will need to hover over RankMath SEO and select the analytics module. So this is the dashboard of the module that will give you an overview of how your site is performing. But that's not our focus. So what we want is to click on the index status tab. Now if you don't see this tab here, then you have to go to RankMath's general settings and under analytics, scroll to the top at the search console, you want to toggle this enable the index status tab on. Now if you haven't connected your Google Analytics and search console with your site, we highly recommend that you do so because the analytics module makes it super convenient for you to get a glimpse of how your site is performing. Check out this video right here to get everything set up in case you haven't done so. Anyway, once you're on the index status tab, you will see an overview of the indexing performance of all the pages of your site. And right below it are all the affected pages and their indexing details. You can filter out the pages based on the issues found. And if you click on one of the pages, you will see the full indexing details of the page. So these are the two ways you can identify the issues. And before we talk about the fixes, we recommend that if you found a page on one of the issues, for example, under the crawled currently not indexed category, we found this page here that is supposed to be indexed. We recommend that you click on it and inspect the URL. Now, as you can see, this URL is on Google and it is being indexed. But why is it that it is still lingering in the crawled currently not indexed error report? That's because there may be discrepancy between the reports in Google Search Console. Google explained that the index coverage report data is refreshed at a slower rate than the URL inspection. So if your page is indexed on the URL inspection while it appears on the error report, you can write this issue off as fixed. So if we are sure that the pages are not indexed and they are having indexing issues, let's talk about the fixes. So the discovered currently not indexed issue is not necessarily a bad thing. It just means that Google needs a little bit more time to process and index the pages. If there are only a few pages in the error report, you can simply inspect the URL. If it is not indexed, you can simply request for indexing and give it a while, and Google will send its robots to crawl your page. It will definitely take some time. However, if the pages have been lingering in this category for a prolonged period, then you should start doing something about it. One of the causes for this issue is if a server is overloaded and Google is having a hard time crawling your pages. So the first thing you should do is to check with your web hosting provider if your site is overloaded and that is causing the crawling issues. If that is not an issue, then it could be content overload, which means that there is an overwhelming amount of content, making it challenging for search engines to crawl and index all pages efficiently. Great examples are if you run an e-commerce store and there are many filtered product category pages, user-generated content, or auto-generated content. If you don't want Google to crawl and index filter pages, for example, you will want to remove links that are pointing to the filter page because search engines discover pages through links. And you also want to add a line of code like this on your robots.txt file so that search engines will not access those pages that fit the criteria when visiting your site. Most likely when you do this, Those filter pages, for example something like this, may be transferred to another issue called blocked by robots.txt, where you can safely disregard them. Now, assuming you do not have a robots.txt file on your web server, there will be a robots.txt available for you on RankMath. Hover to RankMath SEO and select General Settings. On the menu, click on Edit robots.txt, and from here you can edit it. If you want to understand more about how to utilize robots.txt for SEO, check out this video right here. The link is in the description. So as you know, search engines discover and crawl pages by visiting links. So if you have little to no internal links pointing to the flag page, there are two things that happen in the background. Number one, it leaves an impression to the search engines that that page is not as important. As a result, search engines may neglect that page. So you've got to check if there are internal links pointing to the flag page or the page with issues. If you use RankMath, when you go to your post list, check out these three link icons under the SEO details column. This is the number of internal links that are added to this page, and then this is the number of external links added to this page, but these two are not our focus. What we are concerned about is the incoming links, which means how many internal links are pointing to this page. If the number is zero, in other words, it is an orphan page, you want to find relevant articles and place a link to this page. For RankMath Pro users, you have an option right here to filter out orphan pages. Let's click Filter. And as you can see, these are the pages that do not have any links pointing to them. Now, if I were to audit this site, this is a test site by the way, I would say that this site has a poor internal linking structure. Because out of the 11 published articles, 7 of them are orphan pages, which is really bad. You should keep the number of orphan posts at 0, if possible. So if you haven't had any thought of optimizing your internal links, it's time to check it out. If you want to understand what is a good internal linking structure, I highly recommend that you check out two videos. One is about creating a silo structure for your site, and the other is about the different content hubs. And both these videos will guide you towards a better internal linking structure for your entire site. The next item on the list is to check for duplicate content on your site. I mean, if you copy content from somewhere else, you should know that there is a high likelihood that your content will not be indexed, but that's not what we are talking about. We are talking about duplicated content within your site. It could be a printer-friendly page that is duplicated, product variation pages, or whatever. What we recommend you do is to visit a tool like Siteliner.com. We have placed a link to this page in the description. What you want to do is to add your site's URL and analyze it. Give it a while. Once it is analyzed, you can check out the duplicate content and then see which pages have a match percentage of more than 20%. It is normal if it is a category page, a shop page, or the home page. Other than that, if any of the indexable pages, such as those you want to rank for a keyword, have more than 20% match with other pages, you want to click through to see what is duplicated. If, for example, this, it is highlighting grill, which is a rather common word. If you run a BBQ website, you can ignore it. And if you click on this, it is not exactly something important. So if they are just words or a short sentence that matches other pages of your site, it doesn't really matter. But if it is an entire paragraph and it matches many other pages of your site, then you should consider doing something about it. Number one, if it is a legit duplicated page, like a printer-friendly version of a main content, for example, this is the main page, and let's say that this is the printer-friendly version of the main page, we want search engines to rank this page and let them know that this is a duplicated version. So what we want to do is to visit the back end of the page and then click on the RankMath tab, and under the advanced settings, and over here, you want to place the main page URL in the canonical URL field. So you can go to the main page, copy its URL, and back to the duplicated page and paste the URL here. This will tell search engines that this is the main page, while this page that you are on is a duplicated version. And secondly, if you think that the flag page is a poor quality content and that content can be replaced or better explained by another page, for example, this is a thin content page that is with this URL. It is known that this is a low quality page, but there is another page that is well optimized for SEO and it targets similar keywords. Now this page has this URL. What you want to do is a 301 redirection from this page, the low quality page, to a better quality page, which means you do not want your site visitors or search engines to find this page anymore. Anyone who lands on this URL will be redirected to this new URL that is more helpful. To do that using RankMath, you want to hover over RankMath SEO and select the redirections module. If you don't see the module here, it means that you have not turned it on. If that is the case, you want to visit the dashboard, make sure that the advanced mode is selected, scroll down to look for the redirections module, which is right here, and turn the module on. As soon as you have done that, you will see the module here. Let's click on it, and here you can create a redirection. Let's click on add new. Now the source URL will be the URL of the low quality page. So let's go to that page, copy the URL back to the redirection tool and paste it here. And as for the destination URL, this will be the better quality page. So let's go to that page, copy the URL, and you want to paste it here. Now we want to tell search engines that this page has permanently moved to this page. So we want to select the 301 permanent move, and then let's keep the status as active and create the redirection. Once this is done, as we go to the low quality page, take note of the URL here when I hit refresh. So when someone lands on this URL, they will be redirected to the new page. Simple as that. Alright, those are some of the common fixes for the discovered currently not indexed issue. And there are two more things I want to add. One is if your site is relatively new and this issue is very common, so you just have to chill and let Google do its job. But make sure that the content you post are of good quality, of course. Second, I need you to check two settings on RankMath. On RankMath's titles and meta, and on a global meta, you want to make sure that this no follow meta tag is unchecked. If this is checked, it is telling search engines that they should not follow through to analyze the relevance and importance of the page it is linked to. And this applies to all your pages. So you're essentially telling search engines, all my pages are not important. So you want to avoid that. Make sure that this is unchecked. And if there's any changes, make sure that you save it. Now, if the no follow meta tag in the global settings is unchecked, then you want to visit the page that is flagged with the issue. Click on RankMath's tab, and on the advanced settings, you want to make sure that the no follow meta tag is unchecked as well. Following through everything that we have mentioned, I'm pretty sure your pages in the category will be fixed. Now let's talk about the other issue. Crawled but currently not indexed. Now when Google has crawled your page but decided not to index, it could mean two things. One is that the page is not meant to be indexed. For example, the feed page, or this page which is not a typical page for site visitors, or a page that is useful. If we visit it, this page is full of codes. So if this is the case, you can ignore the issues. The same is true for search or filter pages. However, if a page is supposed to be indexed, like for example this page that tries to rank for the keyword best gas grill, or this page that targets the keyword best charcoal grills, when Google crawled them and decided not to index them, then there is a quality issue on those pages. The fixes are not as straightforward, but many of them are what we have already discussed, like removing or canonicalizing duplicated pages, improving the internal linking profile of your entire site. If your page is considered a thin content page, a page is lacking in value, outdated content, etc., you can either remove those pages, redirect them to other pages that are more useful, upgrade the content to make it more useful, or add a no index meta tag to those pages. Those are the fixes. Once you have done whatever you can do to improve the quality of the page, then remember to head back to your Google Search Console, click on the issue, inspect URL, and finally to request for indexing. Alright, I hope with this video you will have a clear roadmap of how to navigate these issues, and if you find this video helpful, how about a thumbs up? Do subscribe to us as well, because we are all about helping you grow your search traffic. This is Jack from RankMath, I'll see you in the next video.